Hello. What was one is now two. The strong find greater strength in numbers. was one is now two. The strong find greater strength in numbers.
That would only slow me down.
Thank you.
Fire rains down across the land. Beware the path you take.
You managed to kill a granddaddy crab. Pity you couldn't lug it out of the caves for us. Could have made quite the chowder out of it. Ah, no matter. We've got one less reason to fear the dark, and I've got one more thing to thank you for.
Hello. A full pocket, severed, spills forth like a struck spring. Full pocket, severed, spills forth like a struck spring.
God bless you on this fine day, exile. And thus, my prayers are answered. None too soon, neither. Don't look so perplexed, exile. Any moment now, this holy spot's going to be... That was some damn divine slaughter you delivered there, Crusader. You did God proud today. You come visit me in Line Eyes Watch next time you're there, for I'm more crusading where that came from.
My mana is gone.
The Earth of Rayclast rejects the dead. The black spirit of storm and dream now reaches into the ground and raises up our slain imperial foes. It leads the fallen from their graves and drives them to fight us beyond the end, rotted tooth and jagged nail. Our own remembered have joined their cursed ranks. No longer may we give our beloved to the birds, messengers of spirit to the sky, conveyors of flesh to the earth. Calm has commanded us to destroy our remembered with axe and fire. Calm is the bravest of us, willing to bear the ire of the ancestors for the survival of his people.
As the prey grows more fierce, so must the huntress.
Let me tell your future. They flee from the eyes of Oria, coated in gold from head to toe.
I've traveled inland, on the Emperor's Road via the Prisoner's Gate. Had to skirt around Axiom Prison. That's the holdfast of Brutus, the Warden. Bloody treacherous trip it was. Worth it. There's forest inland. Game, berries, fruit. More food than we can scrounge here. But most here wouldn't survive the journey. Would be a damn sight easier if we could pass through the prison. Tell you what. You carve us a path up the coast. Find us a way past or through Brutus. And you'll have more than a few lives owing to you.
I've but one purpose in life now. Defend the last vestiges of faith in this godforsaken land. Well, can't be completely godforsaken. He sent you and me here, didn't he? Now, I've a few trinkets lying about that might be of use to you. Adornments imbued with what little faith I can muster in this accursed place. That said, the more corruption we smite, the more faithful I'm likely to be feeling. I can make some damn fine baubles when my divine ire is up. In the meantime, let me know if any of my current pieces catch your eye.
What little help I can offer is yours.
Guidance is priced in silver.
Beauty will grow from your remains.
Welcome. A full pocket, severed, spills forth like a struck spring.
A necromancer? We've got enough undead wandering around without someone raising more for us to deal with. Well, good to see you don't mind getting your hands filthy. Here, have this, to mark a dirty job well done.
There's no justice in a place like this. Only misery.
It's told that Brutus was a man of stature, the warden of Axiom Prison. A man cursed by a twisted enchantment of his own commission. If there's a grain of truth to the tale, then Brutus has my pity. Have this. It may be of some help.
Let me tell your future. I traveled here through death's darkened halls, walking the paths of the remembered. I am but a memory of the woman I was. A memory treasured and sustained by the mother of death. I awoke in the halls of death, with the life I once led, little more than a dream half remembered. Yama the White, my furry companion, stood before me with the seeing stone he holds now. Both were given a hair of Hinekora's dark knowledge, but each serves a separate purpose. The seeing stone drags me deep into its core, where every instant into eternity is known all at once, like limitless rings on a tree trunk. Yama, like a torch in the mist, guides me back from the stone's infinite visions. Hinekora, my mother of death, is not the only god exiled. The Karui are watched over by many. Namahu lends us fire, which illuminates the path. Tafua gives us the trees and birds that line the path, so that we may enjoy beauty and peace. Tukohama provides us with weapons and knowledge of war, which lets us walk the path safely. And in the final days of this world, Kitava, whose hunger knows no bounds, will take it all away. Life flows through the blood. Let slip the blood, and the life will continue in a new form.
There's a fine line between man and monster. Brutus. He well and truly crossed that line. Brutus is a big lad. And as you know from Hillock, big lads are slow. Hit and run. That's the way to cut them down to size. Unless there's magic involved. Then, I'd ask Nessa to light a candle in your memory.
In the court of the goddess, every man and woman is deemed worthy of redemption. Though you might be shackled by the tribulations of the past, the trials ahead offer you both freedom and glory. The future is yours, if you're bold enough to reach out for it.
Life flows through the blood. Let slip the blood, and the life will continue in a new form.
That would only slow me down.
Is the strongest metal of them all. In the court of the goddess, every man and woman...
Hello. The farmer's time came long ago, his ruined home the site of a dark harvest. a full pocket, severed, spills forth like a struck spring.
That would only slow me down.
Oh. An exile here. A shame the warden won't leave anything for me to examine. Make sure you tell our...
Still the Kaurui barbarians advance from the south. Lion Eye is dead, his legion slaughtered. Should the need arise, we shall retreat through Prisoner's Gate, raising my barricade behind us. But our lord Brutus nears readiness. Foul times demand heroism. The warden will serve as our savior. May he crush the Kaurui into the sand with the mighty fists I shall gift to...
I've done for you what I would do for any wounded animal, Brutus.
Hello.
A grand treasure fractures like a dropped mirror, yet somehow goes unharmed.
The warden's finally free of his own prison. Well, since you're so bloody determined to cheat the britches off death, you'd better have this. And when they write the song about you, just be sure to mention that it was Tarkley who taught you everything you know.
For some, death is welcomed with open arms. Did you end Brutus's suffering out of avarice or mercy? Only you know the answer to that one.
own way and land, exile.
Life and death live side by side. This is a strange land.
Frankly, I would have been surprised if you hadn't recognized me. Yes, 'tis I, Captain Sigmund Fairgraves, wave tamer, pirate bane, and conveyor of civilization to barbaric lands. So, what am I doing here, apart from blowing my own bugle? I'm marooned, languishing, thanks to a pair of pretty blue eyes. Stuck fast in the filthy mud of Rayclast, thanks to one sultry little slave girl. I liberated her from the flesh pits of Trathos, and she repaid me in full with sleight of hand and swift feet. Turned the coat of my first mate, took my hard-earned all-flame, and with it the wind out of my sails. Find my all-flame, I beg of you. Till I feel its warmth again, I'm trapped here, high and dry, until the sun's final setting. I hunted the vagaries of a near-forgotten myth to a shattered cathedral in the Inner Empire. I took the All-Flame and encased it within a lantern of pure silver, the only element it seemed incapable of consuming. Oh, the All-Flame does many a marvelous thing in the hands of one who knows how to harness its power. Oh, banish any thoughts of using it for yourself. It would burn you alive. My loveliest neighbor in this most salubrious of neighborhoods. Facing Mervale and finding my all-flame are two mutually exclusive endeavors. I'd much prefer you to live to see your errand fulfilled. Although it is possible that my wayward slave girl fell prey to one of Mervale's slithering progeny. If that be the case, you look resourceful enough to handle a tentacled wench or two. But if Mervale herself has my flame, be very wary. That necklace of hers provides the old siren with some subtle wiles indeed. If the history books are to be believed, Doreso the Daring presented the necklace to Mervale on bended knee. And from the moment he placed that little chunk of rayclast at her throat, Mervale began to sing. It's told her sweet voice grew to fill even the largest concert halls of Oriath, and brought warmth to even the coldest of hearts. But then she began to change. Her mind and body twisted, as did her songs. For the sweetness remained, while the sanity fled. Knowing what little I do about the powers that lie dormant here in Rayclast, I'd surmise that if you have Mervale's necklace, you have the siren's voice.
Calm stands before us and looks out to the raging sea. He sings, calls, screams to our ancestors to come to our aid. He offers them gifts of old, a feast of heart and mind, muscle and marrow, cooked in the fire and rock of this angry land. We have not practiced these ways in so many years.
Poor corrupted creature.
Only in the darkest of times, most desperate of times, do we perform these oldest of rituals. Only here and now may we sacrifice and consume our own. Only in our king can we trust this return to our ancient selves.
Welcome. The circle of silent giants imprisons a memory of undying misery. A dark tongue whispers dark words carried by the western winds.
Mervale dwells in the caves beyond the wrecks. At the head of Siren's Cove. Leave her be, and we can only hope that she continues to return the favor. Tuckley's as good a man as you can find on this godforsaken coast. He has some wrongs to right, no doubt. What they are, I don't really care. If not for him, we'd all be dead. That graveyard of broken ships? It's Mervale's welcome mat. And those poor, haunting souls among the wrecks? There's no happily ever after when you caught one of Mervale's brood. Don't tell Tarkley, but they're the foulest fowl I've ever tasted. Still, exiles can't be choosers. Vestal's ship tore its belly open on the rocks out there, trying to escape from corsairs. The pirates took what they wanted. The scavengers took the rest. Tarkley pulled Vestal from some hideaway in the wreckage, the only one on board to survive. Whether the ordeal turned his mind, or whether it's just his nature, Vestal sails a different course to the rest of us.
My Allflame. My blessed, damned Allflame. Oh, you want your moment in the firelight now, do you? Unfortunately, necessity is what it is, and for the Allflame to give life, it must first be kindled with life. And since suitable kindling is in short supply around these parts, I have little option but to make do with what I have. Namely, you. Please understand that as a gentleman of honor, it pains me greatly to do this. Hard times call for hard hearts. I'm sure were the
good man in a bad situation, Fairgraves.
Fairgraves was a good man, a fine explorer. He opened the door to many a new world, for better or for worse, usually for worse when it came to the natives. There's some peace in the knowledge that he now rests where he should. Let's not speak of Fairgraves again, shall we? He was an inspiration to many. 'Twould be a shame to spoil a good hero.
Tala Moana, warrior.
I give you to the earth.
You are a welcome sight, warrior. Another spirit has reached out to me. This one is close, yet another world away, unless we help him.
That would only slow me down. One rung closer to the top of the food chain. That would only slow me down.
The Kadawi Way grows stronger for every soul that we return to its care. And as the Way grows stronger, we grow stronger. Calm's kingdom fell not to Tukuhama, father of war, but to Kitava, the Black Spirit. With every warrior we save, Tukuhama is blessed, Kitava cursed, and the blood returns to the heart. Spirit and land serve you when you learn to serve your heart. Speak with me the next time you're at Lion Eye's watch. We have more to discuss on the matters of service and reward.
from the eyes of Oria, coated in gold from head to toe.
That would only slow me down. That would only slow me down.
This is love's true face! Fear tastes so sweet! Dinner is served, children! Fear tastes so sweet!
Your love for a man, that's what did this to you, Mervale.
Duresso gave me the gem, kissed me, promised that he would be by my side forever. I sang for him. I sang for Oriath with his gem at my throat. Kalisa's gem. Kalisa's voice. I sang in her echo, performing arias that had once made the Empire weep. I listened to Kalisa's lullabies in my dreams. I gave myself to her music, mind and body. Duresso left me for Sarn with a promise to free me from Kalisa. I begged him not to go, tried to show him the wonder of my transformation, the beautiful daughters he would soon meet. He couldn't see. None of them could see. I fled from their hatred. When Duresso returns, I will cast his cure away. I will teach him what true love is.